introduce former Deputy Station Chief Beirut, Chief of Station Kabul, holder of the Donovan Award, the Distinguished Intelligence Medal, and the only living recipient of the Intelligence Star, Evan Lake. Evan.
You heard? The CIA fell from the Berlin Wall and all the president's men can't put it back together again. It's broke. Not reliable, not trustworthy. Can't stand up to the White House. Backstabbers. Watching porn, tapping phones. Best and brightest quit or retired. What in the name of Jesus Christ nailed to the cross are you doing here? Because you heard the call. Future spread out before you like a cruise ship buffet. You were teaching in a classroom, working in a kitchen, training in a gym, and you heard the call. For some, it was adventure. For some, mystique. For all, it was 9/11, and you heard the call, and it was the call of duty and love of country. Why? Because you have values.
Again, F, we appreciate it.
Did they believe a word of it?
I did.
You're always an easy touch.
Won't be here next year. On my way out.
What? You're a punk. What are you, 40?
Got an offer in the private sector.
You'll miss it.
Maybe I'll come back next year just to hear your speech. Talking to someone down at the farm. Said you gave a real barn burner this morning. What's on your mind?
I have skills better deployed in the field.
Ev, you have been an inspiration to me. I'm not afraid to admit it. I'll look into it. See what I can do.
Come in. Bill?
Want to grab lunch?
Not today.
How'd it go?
Not so good. Director said he's going to see what he can do.
You all right?
Got it tampered down. Getting it under control. Hey, put that dictionary on my hand. It's that book over there, the orange one? It's a dictionary?
I know what a dictionary is, thank you.
There are two kinds of people in this world. Men of action and everyone else.
I'll see ya.
Centrala zice că este transportator, dar nu avea droge la el.
Da, ăștia zic că e posibil să transporte un stick USB.
De unde crezi că va ascunde stick-ul? În pantof?
Probabil în cur. Te las pe tine să-l cauți primul.
Uite-l. Abdi Abdikarim.
În arată nigerian.
Nu este nigerian, este kenian.
Accesul la baza de date.
Yes.
Hilton?
Yes.
This is Bob Deacon at NSA. While back, you put in a watch for a certain chemical cocktail.
This was 3 years ago.
It's over 50 pages.
That's all right. I'll take it electronically.
You know that the only thing standing between me and reassignment is your approval.
Mr. Lake, what do you wish to do when you return?
There's unfinished business.
Well, that's what I wish you would talk about.
Mohammed Benir is alive. They say he's dead. Everybody says. Killed in the explosion.
There was a body.
So what? I didn't see any head. I didn't see Benir's head.
wish to return to work at the CIA...
If I wish to return...
I would strongly suggest that you put the matter of Mohammed Benir behind you.
Fuck!
All the indications pointed that direction, but it wasn't until the PET scan was complete that we could be sure.
No more memory tests?
Just the opposite. Mental exercises have shown to be effective.
All right, what is it? 8 years and I'm dead?
Mr. Wachowski, this is not Alzheimer's. For many years, frontotemporal dementia and Alzheimer's were confused. But frontotemporal dementia is a separate disease.
That's better.
FTD is much more aggressive.
Much more. How much more?
Did anyone come with you today?
No.
The family is very important in a situation like this.
I don't have any brothers or sisters, no children. But work is my family. This frontal FTD, is there anything I should be on the lookout for?
You will be subject to overreactions or inappropriate reactions. Blank spells, perhaps you've noticed this already. Mood swings, unreliable sensory perception.
Unreliable sensory perception. That's what it's called.
There are support groups, social services here in Philadelphia. In fact, wherever you go. I've spoken with Dr. Gross, Nathan Gross, in a special care wing. After we're finished, you'll pay him a visit. He's expecting you. There's no reason to be alone in this.
So what is prescribed?
Usually serotonin inhibitors. Zoloft, Paxil, or antidepressants.
But those are drugs for crazy people. Manic depressives. No, that's not me. Okay, let's get that clear. That's not who I am.
These medications address the behavioral symptoms.
Not the disease.
That's correct.
You seem like...
He hasn't been here all day.
Do you know where he is? Did he call in?
I'm busy, sir. Sorry.
Yeah. Tuesdays.
You're at Ruby Tuesdays?
Yes, I'm at Ruby Tuesdays. That's what I just said.
Okay, which one?
The one in Arlington. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Get this man something to eat, please. And a cup of coffee.
Is that for you?
Hey.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Acetidine, which are only used for clinical trials.
Mediterranean anemia.
Thalassemia, which is hereditary, which we know Mohammed Benir carries, even though he has been dead for 20 years.
You know,
His father died of it.
And Abikaram, the man procuring the drug, was a suspect in a Nigerian fraud ring. Rather than give himself up, he jumps off a bridge. The medical info was on a flash drive.
He ain't no Kenyan.
He was 100% healthy. He had no need for the medication.
What else?
Nothing.
I knew he didn't die. This means his condition has moved to an advanced stage. He can lay low, he can become invisible, but sooner or later, the disease will flush him out.
Binner's got it. It's come out. It's in his blood.
Salam alaikum, Sheikh. I'm going to say.
فين دكتور منتاري؟
وما كان في الحتة يا شيخ. قالوا له راح متوفى. هيرجع غدا بكرة إن شاء الله.
ما جاش حاجة من بوخارست؟
لا يا شيخ.
لما يرجع دكتور يجيبه معك.
نعم يا شيخ. إن شاء الله. باي.
Sorry to impose on our relationship.
What is it?
I've come across intelligence which leads me to believe Mohammed Benir is alive.
Give us the room, gentlemen. Go on.
Benir was believed killed during my extraction. The evidence was circumstantial. Intelligence intercepts led the agency to conclude Benir was dead. He disappeared from our radar. CIA closed the books on him. Not a word about him has been heard for 22 years. Until now. Benir has a hereditary blood disease, thalassemia. If not apparent during childhood, it can lay dormant until midlife or later. There have been recent intercepts of requests for medicine used primarily during clinical trials for this anemia. These requests have a Kenyan source.
And what's the source of these intercepts?
Source is confidential.
Lake, I am the director of the fucking agency. Nothing is confidential. Who's the source?
If the source were to become known, the source would be in danger.
What do you propose?
I would like to set up a task force, establish Benir's whereabouts, extract him, and have him return to the United States for trial.
You'd like to set up a task force?
I meant the agency, sir.
Why don't we just let the man die? That is, assuming that your confidential source is correct, and assuming that it does in fact indicate the presence of man that no one's heard of in 22 years.
Because it is not the policy of this agency, nor is it the policy of this government, to allow the man who's responsible for at least 17 kidnappings, a dozen executions, and the bombing of a tourist bus, some of whom were children, by the way, to go free simply because he's sick.
Ray Sandin Sanjar. Come in. This is Dr. Sanjar. He's with the Office of Medical Services. Please, have a seat. Dr. Sanjar was speaking at UPenn Hospital, a conference on service-related diseases. Did you really think you could travel 150 miles, make three visits to a neurological clinic under a false identity, give blood, leave fingerprints, and not have us find out about it?
Dr. Claiborne forwarded your medical records.
You don't have to worry about payment or privacy or quality of care. CIA takes care of its own.
The OMS is a state-of-the-art facility, in addition to which we coordinate our efforts with AFRH here in Washington.
And we'd like to make this as easy as possible for you. We've been speaking to the DDO. We'll have a retirement dinner. The press, everyone will come. Heck, even the president will be there.
Benir. What about Benir?
Mohammed Benir is dead, Lake. Has been for 22 years.
We interviewed your departmental associates. You're concerned about these mood swings you've been suffering. The unpredictable.
Thank you.
know more about this agency than you'll ever know. Who put you up to this,
huh?
Who's got their hand in your pocket now? I've seen a million people like you. A million people. You've got your head so far up Obama's ass, you can't see anything except his shit anymore. Shame on you. Shame on you.
Agent Lake.
Yes?
The director's asked us to collect your security badge.
Please stand, sir.
Sir, we've been instructed to escort you out of the facility.
Place the items you would like to take. You're on the desk for inspection, sir.
You want to check my aftershave?
There's no need to be snippy, sir.
I want my files! Take them! Here's a couple of them for you. This is what they give to assholes like me who give their lives for their country! What a value! Get someone else to give your goddamn lecture! I resign!
Stuff. I hope you don't mind. I didn't want to leave it there. Can I come in?
Yeah.
Come on.
Thanks. You want something to drink?
Yeah.
Sake?
Sounds good.
Pretty bad today, huh?
No going back.
Look for a retirement party. They're not gonna do nothing about Panera. They treated me like I was some sort of crackpot. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good to see you.
That's the other reason I came. NSA forwarded a copy of Abdi's flash drive. The prescribing physician is Dr. Julian Cornell, Medical Research. That's why none of the indicators went off.
How long has this been happening?
2 years.
Benair.
Well?
Possible Benair. Uses Abdicarum as middleman. Their communications, any information about possible Benair.
Goes into the river. Or so he thinks. And he pays Dr. Cornell.
Ignorant doctor in this.
Well, except for one thing. Dr. Cornell has a Kenyan wife.
How much does he charge?
10K euro every month.
And doesn't report.
Nope.
Now we're on the same page. Doctor's protecting himself. You got the files?
You know what?
What?
This is cool.
Turn them on. I don't like to read off a monitor.
That's him.
That's him.
My fish go up. El Fluz. Sabit.
Fluz Brahim. Uncle Hassan Al Hadi, Yashir.
You have a visa. Speak English. I need you to go to Bucharest. I need you to find this doctor. I need you to get the medication. Shave your beard and get European ways.
therapeutic agents, B, thalassemia, sponsor, Cooley's Anemia Foundation.
Bingo. Mohammed Benir, you think you can hide? Nobody can hide from the Reaper.
Can we get in?
Into what?
Into the correspondence between Benir and the doctor. Cordell hasn't heard from Abdi, so now he's wondering, where's my payment?
It's possible, but...
But what?
If this med is for Benir, why hasn't anyone heard from him in 20 years?
I can explain. Benir thought I had an asset in his group, a double. That's what he was trying to get me to give up. There was no fucking asset. I couldn't give it up even if I wanted, but that was the deal. After my extraction, I had my doubts. So, I sent some intelligence hinting that Benir himself was the double, a cable that would be intercepted at the highest levels. If he was still alive, I wanted him off the playing field. I drove him into the ground. Everybody figured he was dead. I had my doubts.
Why?
Because he's a true believer. Guys like that don't just die. You gotta rip out their hearts with your bare hands.
You've been giving this a lot of thought, haven't you?
Just once a day.
Every day.
All day long. Don't answer it.
To let you push this aside. We want to help you. Come to my office, we'll sit down, have a talk. Prepare for the future. It doesn't have to be tomorrow, whenever you like. Agreed?
Yeah, agree.
I'll see you then.
See you then.
You gonna tell me what that was about?
It's nothing, let's get through.
This goes back to when I found you at Ruby Tuesdays, doesn't it?
Can't man have any privacy?
Look, I'm risking my job here, but you got another program running, something you won't tell me about. You gotta be straight. You owe me that much.
Happy? Not so bad now. Little things. Things I can hide, but that's a train that only runs one way. Everything up here, rotting. Bit by bit, it slips away.
You know this.
I suspected. About a year ago, something in my head just fell. By the time you start showing symptoms, the atrophy's done its damage, brain mass has decreased. 3 years, my guess, that's about it. You know, I want to know something. Were they asking about me?
Not to me directly, but yeah, you're angry.
Not at them. Well, actually, maybe at them, but this whole damn thing. Why me? Why the fuck me? I didn't do anything wrong.
Ev, you still have time left. Make the most of it. Why waste it looking for someone who may not even exist?
He does exist. There is a window here. It won't be open long. And Benir will have gotten away with it. And I am going to do something worth remembering with what's left of my time.
Back to the station. Please get in the patrol car. I will drive you there.
accused of this Nigerian drug fraud scam. What makes him jump?
It had to be something else. Something he knew, something he was afraid he'd give up.
Yeah, something scary.
Money came in. 10,000 euros. Abdi's account.
And no one to pick it up. Shit, I gotta hurry. Clock's running.
You're going to Romania? How? Have you thought about how you're gonna do it?
Go to Bucharest, collect the money, track down the bad guy, charter a jet, set her down at Andrews Air Force Base. No, not in detail.
I'm coming with you.
No, you're not.
Let me come with you.
I'm not helpless.
I know, but do you have multiple ID?
I have old passport.
Old passport won't cut a deal like this. Not in today's security. We'll need at least 3 sets, all vetted.
How long for the IDs?
2 days, 3.
What if I say no?
No what?
No, you can't come.
Well then, Mr. Secret Agent Man, I might have to drop a dime on you.
You know, I half believe you would.
It's programmed to the number I was given. Only calls for emergency. You have cash?
Yes.
So this will be your car.
Do you have it?
Don't tell me anything. I know nothing.
Do you have a gun?
In the trunk.
Have you clarified your plan?
There's a woman meeting us in Bucharest.
Oh, you are full of surprises.
Michelle Zubarian used to be a journalist, Minnie's danger junkie. Might even have been an agent. She works out of Prague, you think.
She an old flame?
Just someone I used to know.
And?
Just, you know, one step at a time. Seeing what'll happen next.
Professor Dr. Julian Cornell. Nothing particularly stands out about him. Gives a low profile, community service, sits on a couple of boards.
What about his wife?
And Gina, they met through an aid program.
Where?
Mombasa.
Sir?
What?
This is another smoking section.
Let me just check something. Yep, I am in Romania. Are you out of your fucking mind? This whole country is a smoking section.
Okay, sir. There is a smoking area upstairs.
I'm putting it out! Jesus!
Thank you for bringing that to our attention.
I'm sorry, Michelle. I'm sorry about that. It's the jet lag. It's got me turned around. What's the best way to approach Dr. Cornell?
In his office. During business hours, closed door with colleagues nearby. I've prepared an official cover. You'll be my American colleagues.
How did you and Michelle meet, if I'm not being too forward?
No, it's not too forward. Just wasn't particularly glamorous.
How did you and Evan meet? That's more interesting.
I was a non-official covert op in Cairo. And I lost an asset. A son of a cabinet minister. My fuck up. Ugly political situation. The agency just stepped back. Then Evan Lake showed up. 2 days later, I was on a plane back to Washington.
They just needed to be reminded to take care of our own. I was a believer then.
You still have it, don't you?
What?
You know what I'm talking about. Show him, Evan.
Yeah, I caught a bullet when I was extracted.
He offered once to have that bullet put in a ring. If I'd agree to wear it on my finger.
said?
Send your glasses.
Doctorul Cornel?
Da?
Natalia Negrescu, Poliția Română. Putem vorbi undeva?
Dar ce s-a întâmplat?
Acestii sunt colegii mei, domnul Awan de la Ambasada Americii și domnul Richards, Securitatea Națională a Statelor Unite. Vă rog.
Biroul meu. In my office, please.
Da.
The citibine is not a prohibited drug, so I don't see why...
Dr. Cornel, I'm here as a liaison. This request has come through official channels. It originates from Washington, D.C.
Washington? Da, pe cine interesează?
English, please.
We have an interest in this person, Abdi Abdikaram. What kind of a name is that anyway?
He said he was Kenyan.
What's your connection to him?
I only met him once at a coffee shop. The rest was through the maids.
When was that?
2 years ago.
You've been prescribing a rare potent drug to somebody you met once in a coffee shop 2 years ago.
He had medical records. He was representing someone else, but the name had been redacted.
You have no knowledge of who's actually using this drug?
None whatsoever. But I did nothing wrong. I did everything by the book.
20,000 euros every 2 months. Does that sound about right?
And why should that be a security concern?
Cornish. 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 Cornell. Dr. Julian Cornell, let us decide what is or isn't a security concern. Rest.
Dr. Cornell, could you please stand up?
What?
Turn around.
What? No, I can't be arrested. I cannot be arrested. You don't understand.
Tell it to your lawyer.
He came into my home last night. My wife was terrified.
Who?
He didn't give his name. He said Abdi was dead. He was an Arab. He wanted the decitabine. And wanted me to go to the patient.
Where?
Didn't say.
Why are you still here?
You asked for my money, didn't you? How much?
30,000.
You're a successful doctor. You're going somewhere you don't know to treat someone you don't know for a lousy 30,000 euros. What am I missing here?
Well, it's my wife. She's from Kenya. He said they'll kill her family if I didn't come.
The Arab man who told you this, is he planning on traveling with you?
I assume so.
You think Cornell will contact us when they call him?
Yeah, he'll call. We got him scared now. We're his only chance. Is there really an Italian Negrescu at SRI?
He's not
going
to contact the Romanian authorities.
Who does he think he is, eh?
I wouldn't trust him if he wasn't. He only wants 15,000 now, so he has to come.
Can we get that much money?
I will write the details. You go send it from the internet cafe. It will take at least a day. The source will ask for more time, you tell him. No, I...
Thank you.
tell me if you go now.
I got anxious. Kept walking. But the thing was, I couldn't remember the name of the hotel.
Lost your wallet. It's just 3 blocks over. You get some sleep. You'll be fine.
It happens towards the end of the day. Sundowning, it's called. Nobody knows why. You get anxious, confused. I had to get out, go somewhere.
You take your medication. You feel better?
Yeah. Yeah, I just slipped. Lost track. I'm all right.
Dr. Cornell called. Money will arrive tomorrow. They said he'd be ready to travel in a few days. Had to get him a Kenyan visa.
When there's our friend.
Yeah. Do you remember what he looked like?
Who?
Veneer.
Of course. See him now.
Back then, when you were a captain, Veneer wanted a name, right? Why didn't you give him a name? It didn't matter which name, any name. It just pissed him off more, hurt the man's pride. If you'd have given him a name, he probably would have said, good. And let you go.
I didn't want to be the man who gave up a name in my question.
Come on. Hotel's this way. Let's go. It's going to start snowing.
I know where the damn hotel is. Stop trying to put a bib on me, okay?
Okay.
Ticket and the money.
Okay.
And the passport.
Just give me a second.
You're out of this. You dodged a bullet. Nothing's gonna happen to you or your people. Now, you can go.
I said
the doctor will arrive on Wednesday.
After that, nothing?
Not yet.
No. Just a few more moments.
What was his phone number again?
254-418-345571. Where is that?
Mombasa. The asshole of East Africa. That's exactly where someone like Benner would end up. That's where Cornell will meet with Benner.
When?
Tuesday. We gotta make Benner think this. What was his name?
Asim.
He's still alive.
Well, all the messages are texts, so he can text.
Yeah, Michelle? Yeah, me too. Look, Milt needs a Kenyan visa. As soon as possible. And there's another thing.
After the base is down, just tone it down a little with a carton board. Are you taking this down? All right. This whole process should take about 2 hours for the first time, and we last the better part of a shooting day.
Shaban works on motion pictures when he isn't helping us out. So if you feel insecure or need a little bit of an ego boost, Shaban's a man for you.
The world is not a pretty place without makeup. The eye color is pretty different.
No. I don't want contacts.
Fortunately, our man wears glasses. So I've added a little thing to this.
Dr. Julian Cornell.
I was able to expedite your Kenyan visa. So, man, what exactly did you see?
I didn't see anything.
What's the mess?
Thank you.
Your visa. You might want to keep it to yourself for a day.
What?
Give Evan another day to think about what he's doing.
He's been thinking about it for 20 years.
22. Evan has retired. It's his life, his choice, but you, no matter how this turns out, it will end badly for you. Your career will be over.
All my life, I wanted to be in the Foreign Service. It was killing me, being strapped to a desk. You should tell him.
I tried. He's made his choice.
La la la. Thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you so much for watching my video.
Michelle had to run. She was able to get my visa, I have it.
I was watching TV, something about a body on university campus. Let's pack up, go to a hotel near the airport, stay in the room until the flight leaves. Just before the flight, text Benir from Asim's phone. Asim says he's been detained by security.
What about Michelle? Are you going to tell Michelle?
What did she ask? Did she say anything about me?
No.
Don't tell her how the story ends.
Thank you.
Yes.
Julian Connell.
Yes.
I am Bui. So glad you could come. I'll take you to Dr. Wangari's office.
Where is Asim?
He is coming.
Mr. Ali Hariri had his last transfusion.
3 days ago.
When is he scheduled for another?
2 days.
Here at the clinic?
Saeed Ali Hariri is being treated at his own residence.
I will see him here.
Dr. Connell, you were given a letter with unexplained. We wrote this.
I am just double checking.
Al Hariri is not able to leave his residence. You requested additional payment in the light of this.
Of course. Let me go through everything tonight. These are for me, correct? And tomorrow I will visit Mr. Ali Hariri at his residence. Will you be coming, Doctor?
Dr. Wangari will not be able to join us. I'll pick you up at the hotel, 4 p.m.
Right. I'll give you $7.50 for the Jericho, $400 for the Glock.
No. 1115.
1150?
Yeah.
Okay, just stop. Here's what we did. 900. 900 from Jericho, 950. All right, no, that's good. That's good.
It's not fair. It's not fair.
Muy.
No, I'm safe.
Come.
I will find him.
Is it you? Is it you?
800, 900. No? All right, look. This is 2,000 euros right here. 2,000 euros right here, okay?
Don't! Don't let me. I have survived much more than this.
I went shopping at the market. Jericho 941. And a Glock.
How much?
2,000 euros.
You got took.
Well, we got euros to spare.
You smell something?
Mombasa.
The other night, when we were in the park in Bucharest, I touched your jacket. You were wearing this blue, like, canvas jacket when I touched it. It felt just like dog fur. The other district knocked it rid of it. It excruciating. It takes over an hour. Maybe I'll just get up close to him, slice him, and let his blood wash all over me.
I don't feel comfortable letting you go in there alone.
I'll be all right.
Look, I picked this up at the market. They're wireless crazy over here. Jump straight from tom-toms to cell phones. Just tuck that in somewhere. I'll be able to hear you, and I'll get GPS as well.
I brought a belt blade. I'll be able to get that through, but that's about it.
So that's that, then.
Yeah. No. Thanks for coming along.
No problem, old sport.
Not out in it.
sleep well.
All right.
Sometimes the heat is a problem.
Come, doctor.
Assalamu alaikum, Saeed Ali Hariri.
Doctor Cornell, thank you. Thank you for coming. Forgive me for not standing. Mbui, some tea.
No, I'm sick.
And those dates.
Mind if I sit? Dr. Wangari has provided me your records, your treatment history. Last night I was in contact with several of my colleagues. Thank you. I noticed you were scheduled 3 months ago for a bone marrow transplant, but I found no record of the procedure. Was there a problem with the donor?
It was too dangerous.
No sibling donor was possible, no compatible cousins.
It is risky, but an unrelated donor can be found based on HL, B, and DR histocompatibility. The University Hospital can assist in finding such a donor. We have a large database. Should have been done before. It is more dangerous now, but we have no choice. At present, transplantation is the only possible curative therapy.
And it can be done here.
Yes. Excuse me, I am not such a young man. Where is the toilet?
Back and to the left.
So sorry.
Oh, please.
I have to be honest. Your condition is far worse than I imagined. Your long-term chances for survival are not good. Neither are your short-term chances. In fact, they are quite hopeless. It's because I'm not a doctor. My name isn't Julian Cornell. And your name isn't Ali Hariri. Your name is Mohammed Benir.
Mr. Luchowski.
Evan Lake.
Boy,
you'll be all right.
Where is your backup? Your elite commandos. Oh, you came alone. How did you find me?
Through the request for experimental thalassemia medication to sit upon it. Family medical history.
It was you. You who sent me into hiding. Years, so for years and years, I live in rooms like this one. I would have gladly given both my ears for my freedom. So, my health is really hopeless.
Yes. You would have died of anemia just like your father.
I was an intellectual scholar. I've read quite a bit myself.
Yeah.
So, how are you going to kill me?
I don't know.
Good. So, we have some time. Perhaps we can have that conversation that I wanted to have that time years ago. You only kept giving me your fake name. Why?
I was making a point.
What point? What is it that you do now? This company. Intelligence analyst. Perhaps you've read some of my writing.
And you're still active.
I contribute. Number of websites not under my name. Of course, you are a religious man, Mr. Lake.
No, I'm not religious.
I think you are. America. You see yourself as a religion, America. I've written about this. The American way of life. Have you been to Greeley, Colorado? You know what I'm talking about.
Say it, Q-Tip. Went from Cairo to Colorado State College in 1948. Said Greeley was like paradise on earth.
So was Julia. Decadence, promiscuity, pop music.
Maybe it's cold outside.
Utoob was repulsed at the flirting and the mixing of men and women and disrespect. So he left, went back to Egypt, and a movement was born. Muslim Brotherhood.
Charles.
Mullahs, ayatollahs, they get rich. They have their origins in prison. Their opponents.
My name is Charles Rachowski. I'm a representative for Spirit Systems.
The only hope for Islam now is Marx. Social justice.
We like the fear. I like the fear. I like the fear.
There are believers, but so many. Truly dangerous people are the ones who follow orders.
Do you think it made any difference? We are dead! You!
Do you?
No!
this.
You have a disease of the blood. My disease is in the brain.
What's the disease?
I'm forgetting things.
There's a lot to forget.
Time for prayer. Oh, will you please help me?
No, I won't do that.
So,
what are you going to do?
I'm going to leave.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Masalama.
Masalama. Yeah, it was worth it. You should have heard him scream. Put the car in gear. God, I hate this time of day. It's the worst.
Would I have a drink?
Should you?
What home?
Oh, come on. Don't be melodramatic. You're retired. You're young. There's tons of things you can do. Or don't retire. They won't put it together. Bucharest, Mombasa. They won't want to.
It was always my dream.
Salam alaikum, asshole. That boy you shot was my friend.
My friend was... What
the fuck does that mean?
Okay.
Haven't you heard? The CIA fell from the Berlin Wall and all the president's men can't put it back together again. It's broke. Not reliable, not trustworthy. Can't stand up to the White House. Backstabbers. Watching porn, tapping phones. Best and brightest quit or retired. What in the name of Jesus Christ nailed to the cross are you doing here? Values. CIA has taken some hits. Some deserved. We've been down on the canvas, but we're on our feet again because we've got no choice and because our country needs us and because we've got what? Values. We'll be right back.
you came to me, you say you love me. When you tend to go, you make other story. The broken heart you brought to my life, the bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came? And why did you give me untrue dreams of living together too long enough? I know your soul as I know myself. You fool with me to date other guys. I know that you don't really love me. I just forgive and try to forget. Don't you really? Our faith has been done. Saturday I've been alone, walking around in the silent sound, till the end of the blurry way. I felt some things blowing my ears. Lonely night, my heart was beating. I'm calling, calling in whisper, till the night blowing.